look at you all. So I think you're probably a little proud of it tonight. I appreciate that you're made room for everybody to fit inside. Welcome to our holiday program. We're excited you're with us tonight. The next song was chosen by one of our members. She had that special privilege because each year we have a donor drive. It's very expensive to have all the musicians here and buy all the music. And so we have a donor drive, and the people that raise the most money for the organization get to choose a selection of music. Last year, coming in second place, accidentally, because I didn't think she won, was Sheila Mulroy. And she chose this gorgeous piece of music called The Night of Silence. We have featured in here two instrumentalists, Linda Lidecker, who is our president of our group. Not only does she sing with us, but she plays beautiful flute. She's a former retired fourth grade teacher here at Reading. And with her, we have Tracy McLaughlin Jessica on oboe. And we're thrilled she's here because her sister, who I thought won second prize, Jamie, got her to play for us.
Travel in shadow.
So when I was searching for music for this program, this one caught my eye. It looked like a lot of fun. And it was described on the website where I found it on as the Christmas song for the selfie generation. Yeah. It was a hit by the singer, actress Kristen Bell and Straight No Chaser, which is a great a cappella group. So of course, I needed to feature a couple of selfie generation kids. So we have the lovely Abby Santana over here and the handsome Jeff Dietz. Who is the son of the handsome Jeffrey Dietz in the 10th century.
Rise up, rise up.
Hanukkah piece, reminding me so much of a Barry Manilow ballad when I first heard it in recording performed. So I decided we had to get a bunch of men who sang as well as Barry Manilow, and in that same lovely crooning voice that I loved in my 20s. So we have here, whoops, and a few dancers that are certainly in. We'll wait for them. To get in place, that was a lot of exertion doing that dance.
Your ears are
from Star Wars. In fact, how many of you have heard of the movie Home Alone? He wrote this gorgeous ballad from Home Alone, somewhere in my memory. And we have a beautiful young woman with a gorgeous voice to sing our special Just Can't. Thank you, Christina. I almost forgot. We have some lovely ladies in bell choir accompanying us as well this piece.
Concert.
I would like to take a moment and publicly thank and recognize Pastor Jamie Michaels and the Old South Church. They've given us a home here where we have our weekly rehearsals, where we store most of our music and equipment, and also they let us use this beautiful sanctuary with a wonderful acoustics to have our holiday concert in. So thank you, Pastor Jamie, and everyone in the church for showing such great kindness to us. I'd also like to thank our director, Beth Mosier, and our accompanist, Joe Beninati. Talented musicians in their own right, but they are also both excellent teachers. And they each have their own special teaching style when they help us learn the music, and it's because of both of them that we continue to grow as singers and we're able to perform these challenging and beautiful music pieces that you're hearing tonight. So another round of applause for Beth and Joe. There will be a reception downstairs in the vestry. You can leave through the back and then go down either staircase. And we have some complimentary goodies and beverages, and you'll get a chance to socialize with the members of the chorus. So now let's continue with our concert. This part of the concert features our guest artists, the Old South Handbell Choir, under the direction of Susan Holloway, who's also the music director here at the church. Now, this choir has been in existence for 40 years. They started in 1977 when they purchased 2 octaves of handbells. And since then, throughout the years, they've performed with many different groups that they regularly bring here in church. Now, handbells have been around for a long time, thousands of years. In fact, the oldest known set in existence was discovered in China and dates back to 1600 BC. They became popular in Europe in the early 1700s, and we were kind of late in the game, and they didn't come to the United States till 1902. The handbells are different from ordinary bells. First of all, they're tuned to specific pitches. So if you look over there, the big bells are the low notes, and the smaller bells are the high notes. They also have handles, hence handbells, and the clappers are different also. In an ordinary bell, the clapper swings freely and just clangs the side of the bell whenever it strikes it. In a handbell, the clapper is on a hinge, so it only swings in one direction, and this gives the ringers more control. Sometimes you might see a ringer holding 2 bells in one hand, and if they want one bell to ring, they might ring it like this, and then the other bell, they would just switch their hand and ring it like that. Because of this hinge mechanism. To ring a bell, the ringer will hold the bell upright, tip it back slightly, and when it's time for the note to sound, they'll snap their wrist and then move the bell in an arc. When it's time for the note to stop, the bell needs to be dampened somehow. Oftentimes you'll see a ringer just touch the bell to their body and the clothing will dampen it. Or you might see them put it on a padded surface like a table, or sometimes they even dampen it with their thumb. Unlike other instruments where one musician plays all the notes in the song, like the flute, the bell ringers share the notes, so a bell ringer may only be in charge of a few different notes in the song. While this sounds easier, it isn't. It's much more difficult. It requires extremely precise rhythm to know exactly when the note you're in charge of needs to ring and when it needs to stop. So for example, let's say I'm a ringer in a choir and we're going to play Jingle Bells and I'm in charge of one note, E. So I have the bell for E and it might go something like this. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey. So I was doing one note watch them. They do multiple notes. There are other ways to ring a bell, too. You might see a ringer shake a bell, and that's called trilling. Or sometimes there's so many notes that need to be done that they might use mallets, and that also gives a special staccato effect. So now, with your new handbell knowledge, as the choir plays, I want you to watch how the ringers use their bells. I want you to notice how the bells are dampened, and I want you to appreciate the teamwork that it takes for them to play the beautiful music you're about to hear. So now please join me in welcoming Susan Holloway and the Old South United Methodist Church Handbell Choir.
Thank you.
Get to audition to join the chorus, because we're going to invite you to sing along with us for our annual holiday sing-along. In your program, on page 8, you will find the lyrics for any of the songs you don't already know by heart, and looking forward to hearing your voices join ours.
Jingle bells, jingle.
verses 1 and 2.
Thank you.
ball, the conductor, too. That was a really nice recital at the end. Good job. Going to invite the bell choir to join us on this next piece, Christmas is Coming. You might note there's a very tall trumpet ringer who's no longer ringing. That's because now she's singing. Okay, tough job. I want to take this moment while the bell's getting set to introduce you to some of our members. This is quite a family, the Brave Community Singers. It's just like the name. And some of us are actually really related to each other, even though the rest of us wish we were. How many people in this group are married to somebody else in this room, in this front stage? Okay, me too. How many of you have a sister or brother on this stage? How many of you have a really dear close friend on this stage? How many of you have someone in the audience you love? I hope all the hands are up. So we're quite curious. How many of you love somebody up here? Oh, stand some of this. I don't know. Are you ready? Throughout the globe. absolutely stunning. It was written by the phenomenal Leonard Cohen, who passed away a year ago last month. So I hope we'd sung this a few years ago. Everybody really loved it, so I thought it was a nice support and to honor Leonard Cohen. We have lots of fabulous soloists for you, both male and female.
Thank you. famous coursers, but did you know there's one more famous than all the rest put together?
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
That's right, it's Rudolph. But did you know that Rudolph had a second career? He was a vaudeville performer. His act will slay you.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny nose. And if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games.
Okay, we've told you about dying reindeer so far. But did you know there's a tenth one?
A tenth one?
I didn't know there was a tenth reindeer. What's his name? Surname, actually.
Olive.
Olive? I didn't know it was an olive.
Sure you did. It's right in the song. Olive the other reindeer.
Why did you not go to school?
Because I'm Elf Todd. What's my favorite game?
I don't know. What is your favorite game?
Stable tennis. What are you calling when I'm wearing earmuffs?
I don't know. What do I call you when you're wearing earmuffs?
Anything you like. I can't hear you.
But so are your eyes. Between
your last opportunity to lift your voices along with us tonight. We're going to be doing the Holly Chorus from Handel's Messiah. We used to invite you to come up on stage with us. However, we can hardly fit up on the stage with us. And you're pretty crowded in the auditorium already. So enjoy from where you are. Please feel free to sing with us. If you want to stand and hit those high notes, it does help. And Holly Chorus.
Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Before we start our last selection, I'd like to remind you we're having a lovely reception downstairs with drinks and food for you. We'd love you to come down and meet the people up here that love you, that raised their hands for you before. I also want to take this opportunity to thank my bandmates. My band have been tremendous, worked really hard. We have Mark Yudkowski on trumpet, piccolo trumpet. A former colleague of mine from Burlington Public Schools, which is very well represented throughout this room today. Thank you, folks. We have Joe Lentino this year on trombone. Thank you, Joe. We welcome Steve Goldback on saxophone and clarinet. You've heard him play a couple of games. Tristan McLaughlin Jasper on oboe. Jack Butler, also from Burlington Public Schools and my college alumni as well. This last selection have also features some fabulous dances, and you're going to have a lot of fun and a couple of surprises, because that's how we play around here.
Bye.
thank you all for coming this evening. We love to have you here. We're looking forward to seeing you downstairs. If you could exit through the back and we can exit through the rear, we won't get killed.